You have, you're seen as part of the kind of reformist, pragmatic, moderate part of Iranian politics. You've called Iran a democracy. You've called it a democratic system in the past. And of course, your president, Rouhani, has been elected twice, overwhelmingly by the Iranian people. But his boss, the supreme leader of Iran, Ayatollah Khamenei, wasn't elected by the people, has been in office for nearly 30 years. And if you insult him, you risk going to prison in Iran. How is that democratic by any definition of that word?
I question your premise, because the leader in Iran is also elected. Please check our constitution.
29 years ago.
No. And he can be removed any day by a body that elected him. And that body was elected by the people. Every country has their own...
The Assembly of Experts.
The Assembly of Experts.
But the Guardian Council, which he appoints, has a veto over that.
Has a veto over what?
Over the Assembly of Experts, in picking the members of the Assembly of Experts.
No. He cannot.
But he's not popularly elected by any definition of the word. And he's been in power for 29 years.
He was actually popularly elected twice.
For a 29-year term?
No. Popularly elected twice as president.
Yes.
And I've not disputed the Iranian president is elected.
Okay. I'm saying the Supreme Leader isn't.
And then we have a constitution that was approved twice by a referendum. In that constitution, there is a constitutional process. And in that constitutional process, there is an office of the supreme leader, and that office is elected and then observed by the Assembly of Experts. This is the constitutional mechanism.
For 29 years.
Some people lead countries, democratic countries, for longer than that. No. But it doesn't mean that they're not a democracy.